मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चरल पार्ट ऑफ द मसल एंड द फाइन स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ सार्कोमियर. वी हैव डिस्कस्ड एंड इन द सार्कोमियर वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट एक्टिन, मायोसिन, ट्रोपोमायोसिन, ट्रोपोनिन एंड द स्ट्रक्चरल प्रोटीन ऑफ जेड लाइन, एम लाइन एंड ए बैंड. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द मैकेनिज्म ऑफ मसल कॉन्ट्रैक्शन, हाउ the muscle is contract and relax. It is the topic of today's lecture. Myself, Dr. Ashok Kumar Siroya, Department of Zoology, SPC Government College, Ajmer. Back to the mechanism of muscle contraction. A muscle fiber contracts when it is stimulated by nerve impulse, electrical impulse, or mechanical stimulus. The skeletal muscle contracts when it is excited by these stimulus. Excitation also known as depolarization of that muscle fiber, which cause development of action potential in the muscle fiber. This is an electrical phenomenon. The axial potential travels along the muscle fiber and through a sequence of events causes muscle contraction. This is a mechanical phenomenon. So the muscle contraction involves two types of phenomena. First is electrical phenomena and second one is mechanical phenomena. These two phenomena are linked together by release of calcium ion. Therefore, the process by which depolarization of muscle fiber initiated contraction occurs also known as initiation contraction or excitation contraction coupling. In a resting muscle fiber, the sarcolemma is electropositive outside and electronegative inside. Thus, it has the resting membrane potential of minus 90 millivolt and is said to be polarized. It is also called RMP, resting membrane potential. The skeletal muscles are supplied by large medullated nerve fibers originated from motor neurons of spinal cord. These nerve fibers innervate the voluntary muscles by neuromuscular junction. So we can say the neuromuscular junction is a junction between nerve cell and muscle fiber. This junction transfers the spinal signal from nerves to muscle, which spread into the wall muscle fiber. This is the point where a synapse of an afferent nerve makes contact with the muscle fiber. So this is a contact of nerve to the muscle. The sensory nerve supply to the muscle is afferent, while the motor supply is known as efferent supply. The neuromuscular junction the nerve synaptic knob rests over the plasma membrane or sarcoplasma of muscle fiber. This is known as end plate. The synaptic cleft of about 200 to 300 angstrom width also found between axon terminal and muscle fibers. Axon terminal buttons or knobs contains numerous synaptic vesicles having acetylcholine as an excitatory transmitter. Here we can see the neuromuscular junction in this diagram. This is the axon knob, and this is the muscle fibers motor end plate, and in between knob and this end plate, the space found known as synaptic cleft. When nerve impulse approaches to the motor neuron axon, the synaptic vesicles release some neurotransmitter like acetylcholine, and the neurotransmitter is absorbed by motor end plate of the muscle fiber membrane, and it reaches to the other part of muscle fiber membrane. The neuromuscular junctions, as we can see in this animation, the action potential arrives at the presynaptic terminal, causing voltage-gated calcium ion channels to open, increasing the calcium ion permeability of the presynaptic cleft. Calcium ion enters the presynaptic terminal and causes vesicles to release their neurotransmitter acetylcholine from the synaptic vesicles into the presynaptic cleft like this. Now, the diffusion of acetylcholine across the synaptic cleft and binding of acetylcholine to acetylcholine receptors on the postsynaptic muscle fiber membrane, or we earlier said it as the end plate of muscle fibers, causes an increase in the permeability of ligand-gated sodium chain. Synaptic cleft now filled with acetylcholine. The acetylcholine attached to the end plate receptors, and these end plate receptors take these receptors into the muscular system. movement of sodium ion into the muscle cell result in depolarization of the postsynaptic membrane. Once the threshold has been reached, means the sodium ions movement has their highest limit, the postsynaptic membrane depolarizes and the action potential is generated and propagated towards the other part of the muscle cell membrane like this. And then acetylcholine is rapidly broken down to acetyl and choline. Choline is reabsorbed and by the presynaptic terminals and combined with acetic acid to form more acetylcholine, which enters the synaptic vesicles. So the action potential is generated and propagated by the neurons and neuron attached to the neuromuscular junction. So the via neuromuscular junction, neuron send their impulse or electrical signals to the muscles. Action potential generated. In next class, we will discuss about different mechanism of muscle contraction.